I saw you. Didn't know loss till I lost you.
Yeah, we love these guys. The talented duo Jacko Pierce is celebrating their 25-year anniversary, and they're in Dallas for a special event tonight, which you can all be a part of. So welcome back to the broadcast, Jack O'Neill and Carrie Pierce. Hey, guys.
Hi.
Good morning.
Good morning. To have you guys back.
Thank you.
It's great to be here.
Okay, so tell us about this performance.
It's like one of the biggest things, maybe the biggest thing we've ever done. We're playing with the Dallas Symphony. It's tonight. It's free. It's in Clyde Warren Park. And it's just like, we rehearsed with them yesterday at the Meyerson, and we were just
blown away.
Yeah, I was like trying to hold back the tears. I was like, I will not cry.
How crazy is it to start, you know, back in the day, y'all started when I was at SMU, just simple, early days, yeah. And now your Dallas roots have grown and grown and grown, and now you're playing with the symphony. What is that like now?
It's amazing. We're celebrating 25 years.
Wow.
And so last year we played the Windspear Opera House, and I think just being down in the Arts District got the Clyde Warren Park got wind of us and was like, hey, we want them to come play over here. Mm-hmm. So they started talking about it and working out with the DSO. And I mean, we just feel blessed that we are in the position to be able to do that.
And that is still so lovely. So cool. Interesting story about the Meyerson. So Scott, you know my fiance Scott.
Yeah.
You guys are friends. He saw Tony Bennett there. And Tony Bennett was telling everyone there are only two places that he's ever played in the world that has acoustics. Great acoustics,
like that,
and the
yeah.
Meyerson was
wow.
one of them, and
wow.
so he would sing with no microphone because it was just so amazing.
Oh,
so,
that's cool.
That is great.
That's
now,
25
years, though. Okay, let's get real. Do you guys ever get sick of each other? Like, are you just like, we're done? 25 years is a long time.
I think
time.
Yesterday he was done.
Done?
I was kind of done, yes. No, well, we've had a couple
yesterday.
Moments. There was a period for about 5 years mm-hmm. where we just didn't do any music. And I moved to New York quite
a
while ago. So,
oh,
yes,
there you
yes.
go.
Right. But we figured it out. Now we know. Now we know how it works best.
And, distance works, right?
What's different about the music you're doing now, post-split, mm-hmm. as opposed to the music that you were doing before?
It's a lot better. No, I'm kidding.
And I'd imagine so, because like everything, it probably mm-hmm. morphs into something more mature and more.
Yeah. So, well, we did a lot when we before.
Oh, look at that old school! Look at that.
I don't even want to know
it's
what that
old
is.
Video. Oh, you see his hair. Look at his hair. Brood.
Is
the brood.
That
yes. The Jack O'Neill
yeah,
brood.
Hair.
Look, not a smile.
Look at that hair.
Oh,
yeah. Well, that was that you.
That was an actor.
We had some hair back then.
What you were saying about how the music is different.
Well, I think before we did a lot of writing on our own, and now we're able to come to each other and say like, hey, I'm halfway there, or whatever it might be. You know, give me a hand, I trust you at this point. So I think that's a maturity and a, mm-hmm. you know, just kind of getting into the next place of our relationship.
Your bromance.
Who does the bulk of the writing? Do you collaborate or does somebody take the lead on the lyrics?
We both do, both. I mean, it's just sometimes he's got some lyrics, sometimes he's got some music, sometimes we come together, sometimes I've got something that needs to be finished and vice versa. So it's a
collab. You never know. It's a question we get a lot. You know, what do you write first, the lyrics or the music? Mm-hmm. And sometimes it just
comes together.
You're just lucky to get it. That's what it really comes down
and
to.
And how many albums is this for you guys? Like, they're like, we don't remember. There are too many.
We're probably losing count at this point. It's in the teens at this
wow.
point.
Very
Cause
cool.
we just came out with Live 25, mm-hmm. which was the recording from that Windspear show last year. And which we're just grateful to our team for putting that all together and making it happen. Cause we were like, oh, there's so much stuff going on. We didn't think like, oh, we need to record this, mm-hmm. but I'm glad we did because it's a really nice, it's the first time we've ever done a full multi-track, like real deal live recording.
Wow.
With a band, with a duo, with guests. It was mm-hmm. a lot of fun.
Very nice. And of course, you guys are so busy with your singing and your albums and touring. And how do you balance that with your family life? It's hard, you know, and you guys are on the road a lot.
Yeah. It's probably like y'all, we sprint for a while and then mm-hmm. we're chill for a minute and then we sprint. And my family's just super supportive, so is his. His son and his parents are flying in from D.C. Mm. My mom and dad aren't coming. Unfortunately, my mom got sick, so aww. They're not coming in. But my wife will be there, and my 14-year-old son will be there, and my little boys will be at home. But his
your
boy's coming in.
Your 14-year-old plays, doesn't he?
He plays.
Very
hopefully
musical.
He'll join us tonight. I hope Jordan will join us tonight.
Oh, that'd be awesome.
That's
neat.
Yeah.
Well, it's going to be a beautiful night out there.
Right.
Yeah.
So hopefully everyone's just going to come on out. And
sure.
And enjoy y'all again in Dallas.
And the
Dallas.
Food trucks will be out there, hopefully,
the
too.
Food trucks.
Nice. Food trucks.
Yeah, and if you want to sit up close, you bring a blanket.
Yep.
If you want to bring chairs, you got to sit further back.
Sure.
So if you want to get up close.
And we could bring some good wine.
Yeah.
Right?
Yes.
No?
Can
we?
I don't know if you can bring...
You can't bring your
they
wine?
They do have bars on site.
Will they be serving wine there called Weather?
I tell you, no, that's funny you ask that, because the only restaurant, the only venue in all of Texas that is serving our new wine, which is called Weather Pinot Noir, which is a 2012 Russian River Valley Pinot Noir, for those Pinot files out there. The only people serving is Lark on the Park, which is a restaurant right next
right
to the
there,
park.
Right there, which is
so
a great
encouraging people
by the
to
way.
Go have dinner there tonight, make a reservation. It's going to be packed.
Right.
And then go over
we
the
park.
We
are going to hear so much more about that new venture a
yes.
little bit later in the show, because this is something that we really want to hear about.
Amy got started.
I feel like wine and music go together
once
perfectly.
Once you say do. Cork, we're going to start talking wine.
Of course they do.
Okay, right now, if you are our second caller and our third caller, you're going to take home one of Jaco Pierce's CDs. So give us a ring at 800-994-1547, and good luck to you. And when we come back, as promised, we're going to talk about this other project that Jaco Pierce has taken on, this duo is taken on, has a lot to do with one of my favorites.
Dance.
Dance,
a new dance project.
It's ballet.
It's a ballet. Come on back.